Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. In 1997, when the world's first hybrid vehicle, the Toyota Prius, was unveiled, the world was astonished by its ingenious design. The engineer who developed this system must be an absolute genius. At present, this system is the most fuel-efficient hybrid system in the world. This video explains the unique structure and detailed operation of the system. The Toyota hybrid system consists of an engine, two electric motors, a planetary gear set as a power split device, a traction inverter to control the electric motors, and a hybrid battery. Before going into details, we will first learn briefly about the operation of planetary gears. A planetary gear consists of three main components: an internal gear, a sun gear, and a planetary carrier, along with planetary pinions that rotate as a unit with the planetary carrier. By assigning input, output, and fixed roles to these three components, it is possible to increase speed, reduce speed, or reverse rotation. Step-type automatic transmissions shift gears using this function of the planetary gear set, whereas the Toyota hybrid system utilizes a different function. We will cover that later. So for now, just remember that the planetary gear set shifts using three elements. In the Toyota hybrid system, the two electric motors switch roles between generating power and producing output, depending on the situation. For this reason, the electric motors are called MG, motor generator, and the two electric motors are named MG1 and MG2, respectively. MG1 is connected to the sun gear of the planetary gear set. The shaft of MG1 is hollow, and through it, the engine is connected to the planetary carrier. MG2 is connected to the internal gear, and the output is transmitted from the shaft of MG2 to the differential gear. Let's take a look at how the hybrid system operates under various driving conditions. During acceleration from a stop, the vehicle is driven solely by the output of MG2. At this time, since the engine is off, the planetary carrier is stationary, while the planetary pinions and sun gear rotate freely. When the vehicle's speed reaches a certain level, the engine starts. For engine startup, MG1 operates as a starter motor and rotates the engine via the planetary gear. When driven by the engine alone, the engine's output is transmitted to the differential gear via the planetary gear and MG2 shaft. At this time, the planetary gear functions as a continuously variable transmission, CVT, allowing the vehicle speed to change while keeping the engine speed constant. The planetary carrier is connected to the engine, the sun gear to MG1, and the internal gear to the wheel. MG1 operates as a generator and alters the rotational resistance of the sun gear. Increasing the power output of MG1 raises the rotational resistance of the sun gear, making it harder to rotate. Decreasing the power output reduces the load on MG1, which also lowers the rotational resistance of the sun gear. The engine speed is constant now. The power generation of MG1 reaches its maximum, and the rotational resistance of the sun gear increases to its highest level, causing it to stop. At this time, the internal gear rotates faster than the planetary carrier. In other words, it results in a top gear state, where the output rotational speed is higher than the engine speed. Lowering the power output of MG1 increases the rotational speed of the sun gear. This causes the rotational speed of the internal gear to decrease, which is the low gear state. In this way, By continuously varying the load on MG1, the vehicle speed can be changed while keeping the engine speed constant. What is remarkable about this system is that it achieves control of the Sun Gear's rotational speed without using energy-consuming devices, such as hydraulic pistons or electric servo motors. Not only does it not consume energy, but it even charges the battery. This mechanism gives the Toyota hybrid system excellent fuel efficiency. This system also has its weaknesses. These graphs show the performance curves of a typical gasoline engine. Let's take a look at the acceleration behavior. By combining a step-type automatic transmission in the left graph and a CVT in the right graph, with a CVT, the engine can shift within its most efficient speed range, providing excellent fuel economy. However, because acceleration and engine speed changes do not match, it may create a sense of discomfort for the driver. This phenomenon, known as rubber band effect, is disliked by some drivers. However, for Toyota's hybrid vehicles, which don't even have a tachometer in the first place, this may not be considered a weakness. During rapid acceleration, the engine and MG2 combine their output to generate strong driving force. During deceleration, MG2 operates as a generator, and its resistance is used as braking force. This function is called regenerative braking. In vehicles with internal combustion engines, the friction brakes convert the vehicle's kinetic energy into heat energy, which is then dissipated into the atmosphere to slow the vehicle down. In other words, energy is being wasted. In hybrid vehicles, regenerative braking converts the vehicle's kinetic energy into electrical energy, which is then stored in the battery. The stored electrical energy is used during the next acceleration, which reduces the load on the engine and leads to improved fuel efficiency. Regenerative braking is implemented not only in the Toyota hybrid system, but also in other hybrid systems and battery electric vehicles. In hybrid vehicles with small capacity battery, problems can occur under certain conditions. When driving down a long downhill slope, regenerative braking operates for an extended period, causing the battery to become fully charged. Since no more power can be generated, regenerative braking does not operate. In this case, the engine is activated and engine braking is used, just like in a conventional engine vehicle. Although the driver performs the same actions, the vehicle's behavior differs depending on the battery's charge level. This is one of the weaknesses of the Toyota hybrid system, which can cause a significant sense of discomfort for the driver. We have learned that the two motor generators can be used as both motors and generators. But what does that actually mean? This animation shows the simplest electric motor. The relationship between the magnet and the electric current flowing through the wire generates rotational force, causing the motor to rotate. When a higher voltage battery is connected, the rotational speed increases. On the other hand, when an external force rotates the motor, it operates as a generator and produces electricity. If it is rotated faster, it generates more electricity. The motor in this animation is a DC motor, while the one used in hybrid vehicles and battery EVs is a three-phase AC motor. The traction inverter controls the switching between the drive motor and generator, as well as the rotation speed and power generation. A three-phase AC motor consists of three coils, U, W, and V, along with magnets, and the traction inverter controls them using six transistors. A transistor is a semiconductor that can turn a large electrical current on and off using a small electrical signal. When the traction inverter control unit turns transistor 1, 3, and 5 on, electricity from the battery flows into coils in the motor. When the coils are energized, the magnetic field inside the motor changes, generating a rotational force on the rotor's magnet and causing the rotor to rotate. When the control unit turns off transistor 3, the magnetic force of coil W disappears, causing the magnetic field inside the motor to change. A rotational force is generated on the rotor's magnet, causing the rotor to rotate. When the control unit turns on transistor 6, coil W is energized. The magnetic field changes again, generating rotational force on the rotor magnets and causing the rotor to rotate further. By repeating this operation, the motor continues to rotate. When the transistor switching interval is increased, the motor operates at low speed. And when the interval is shortened, the motor operates at high speed. When the motor generator operates as a generator, the power generation is also controlled by switching the transistors on and off. When all transistors are turned off, the circuit to the battery is completed, allowing the battery to be charged. When transistor 4 to 6 are turned on, the circuit is not completed, so the motor generator does not generate electricity. Using this effect, MG1 controls the CVT, while MG2 controls the regenerative braking force. The transistors used in the traction inverter are called power transistors because they handle high currents. The power transistors used in hybrid vehicles and battery EVs are IGBTs, insulated gate bipolar transistors, which come in two types, silicon-based SiIGBTs and silicon carbide SiCIGBTs. Compared to SiIGBTs, SiCIGBTs offer higher efficiency, but they also come at a higher cost. Battery EVs that run solely on battery power have stricter demands on inverter efficiency. So newer battery EVs use SiCIGBTs. However, as of now, there seems to be no information indicating that SiCIGBTs have been adopted in hybrid vehicles. One reason for the fuel efficiency of the Toyota hybrid system is the adoption of the Atkinson cycle engine. An Atkinson cycle engine refers to an engine with a mechanism in which the piston strokes during the intake and expansion phases are different, as shown in this animation. However, the engines used in the Toyota hybrid system do not feature such a complex linkage. Instead, they vary the effective piston stroke by delaying the closing of the intake valve. This type of engine offers better fuel efficiency than engines of the same displacement, but has lower power output. In the Toyota hybrid system, the high fuel efficiency of this engine is fully utilized, while its low power output is compensated by the assistance of an electric motor, resulting in excellent overall fuel economy. This channel offers a detailed video explaining the Atkinson cycle. If you're interested, be sure to check it out. The link is in the description. The first generation system extracted power from the internal gear shaft via a chain. The two-stage reduction type equipped with a two-speed transmission was developed for FR vehicles. The second generation system retains the same mechanism as the first generation, but features significant improvements in the motor, battery, and control technology. The third generation featured a planetary gear reduction system to reduce the speed of the high-voltage, high-speed electric motor. In the fourth generation, the reduction gear has been changed from a planetary gear system to a parallel shaft system to reduce size and drive loss. The multi-stage hybrid system is designed for FR vehicles and is equipped with a four-speed transmission. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.